Bonjour guys, welcome to a brand new FIFA 20 video, and today we will share our thoughts and our opinions about the brand new FIFA 20 demo gameplay. Why do we think it's a generally good demo, and what else can be improved from EA Sports for the official release of FIFA 20? So guys, as well, in the comment section down below, let us know what you guys think about the demo. Do you think it's a good or a bad demo? And let us know more details about your impressions. So guys, as well, leave a like and make sure you do subscribe to the channel to not miss out, of course, more FIFA 20 videos. My first big impression concerning the demo is that it feels like a brand new football game, and this is something really important, and this is something that I needed for FIFA 20 boys after the mess we had in FIFA 19. Yes, indeed, the foundations of FIFA 20 are completely different from FIFA 19,
yes,
which is pretty good if you guys ask me. Now bros, as well, talking about the game, the pace is much slower. It's hard because we need to adjust to a brand new, slower gameplay.
Yes.
I love it because I love football. And in football, sometimes you don't have 90 minutes where I'm playing or just running around everywhere. Sometimes there is some dead moments. And I find that pretty cool with FIFA 20 is that you can finally take time to build up the play, to play like real football, to create in the midfield, to take your time whenever you have the ball. And as well, defensively, you don't rush defensively. You don't put your position, your players out of position too much. So I think this is a really good football simulation so far.
Exactly, boss. This is as well something important because when I play FIFA, I want the game to be realistic. I don't want to play FIFA when it's like 4-4 at like the 45th minute. No, this is not what I want. Scoring goals in the FIFA 20 in the demo, it's actually super hard. But it's rewarding when you score. And if you play smartly, if you play with football, with the football knowledge that you guys have, you can actually win the game with only 1-0. This is something super rare concerning both the FIFA 19, the previous FIFA that we had. But as well, the big thing that we need to say as well is that the gameplay of the demo is offline. That means the pace of the game will be much faster whenever we're gonna have the full game on FIFA 20.
And this is what scares me, because I know when I take a look back at the FIFA 19 demo, the FIFA 19 demo was really slow. The FIFA 20 demo is really slow as well. But as soon as Ultimate Team and as soon as FIFA 20 is out, the tempo, the vibe of the game is much faster. So this is what I'm worried about, is that EA Sports, within the first couple of weeks, they do a patch where they speed the game up by a lot. And I think that would be a big mistake, because we need the pace of the game to be slower. After boys, of course, talking about the pace of the players feel way more balanced, because back on FIFA 19, Mbappe, someone like Matip could have catch up Mbappe. No, in real life, that's not happening. But in FIFA 20, now it's more realistic by the fact that Mbappe will not get catch up by defender because he does have 96 pace. So I think this is really more realistic, and this is way more balanced. In FIFA 19, every defender's were catching up against every striker, which made no sense.
Not set whatsoever. But as well, this is something that was really interesting, that I do think FIFA 20, the gameplay so far that we had for like 2 days, I actually think it's a good gameplay. But there's a couple things that can be improved, but that's a demo as well, you know. The sole purpose of a demo is to sell the gameplay in a way, so the gameplay is always better in a way, boys, for the demo. Nonetheless, the passing of the game, it's really hard to make great passes, but I don't know if you guys realize, if you make a great pass, it's actually rewarding whenever it's going through, so that's gonna be awesome as well, because in football, if you switch side from one side to another, there's gonna be some mistake. You're gonna sometimes lose the ball. This is not gonna be as precise as you want, and I do think in FIFA 20, boys, it's actually the same thing as in real life, so that's something really cool from the improvement that we had those previous FIFA.
Yes, it's way more rewarding whenever you make a good pass. And this is why now the passing stats for FIFA 20 is going to be super important. Yes. So I think talking about Ultimate Team, it's going to be cool to see people using more passing with chem styles. The chem style for passing, it will be more cool instead of always having Shadow or Hunter.
Yeah.
That could be quite cool. Now, boys, as well, talking about the dribbling. This is something that I'm really passionate about, because I do love dribbling in real life and as well in FIFA. It's okay. Dribbling is not the best. It's a brand new mechanic, so I still need to get used to it. There's couple things that need tweaking. Hopefully EA Sports will get it right, especially when they're talking about the balance of the player. I think EA Sports sometimes can do a better job with this.
Yes.
Hopefully they can fix it whenever FIFA 20, the official game, is out. Now, skill moves. Skill moves. I love it. I absolutely love it. Simply for the fact that now you cannot do 15 skill moves in a row and this will simply not work. If people want to do a lot of skill moves, they go to Volta and that will be everybody's happy. What I love about skill moves is that they're effective. Skill moves have to be effective because every time you master a skill move, this is something that you worked and you spend time on.
It's a strength.
Skill move needs to be effective. So far, there's a couple skill moves here and there that are pretty overpowered. Nothing like La Croqueta like last year. I'm talking about when people did 15 La Croquetas back to back and you cannot defend. This is not happening in FIFA 20, which is awesome.
Exactly.
As well, talking about the skill move, it's a lot more realistic. It's a lot more realistic because if you do a couple skill moves in a row, then the ball will go
far away.
And I think this could be a strategy, guys. If you guys analyze and utilize this for your full potential, I think this could be a good strategy whenever you do couple skill moves in a row.
Exactly, boss. And I do actually think what FIFA 20 can improve, or EA Sports can improve, is actually the fact when you can feel the agility of some players. Because,
yes,
for example, on the demo I played with Mbappe, with Johnny, will have a lot of agility, or someone like Neymar has a high balance, high agility, and he didn't feel like he had a lot of agility and balance. Maybe it's me because it's a new game, but he doesn't feel like a high agility player. And I want this to change for FIFA 20 when the full game will be released, to feel more the agility of some players, because I feel when I play the demo that all my players are like center backs in a way, and I don't really like that. I want some of my forwards with a lot of agility to go fast and to be agile whenever they have the ball, and to be fast when they make some dribble, when they make some skill move.
I totally agree with you on this, Vincent. Now for the shooting, I think it's good so far. I think the shooting mechanics are pretty good. There's multiple ways to score, and I think that's awesome. There's not only crossing or only like finesse shot from like 45 yards. I think right now there's multiple ways to score. The time finishing is more balanced. If you guys want to do the time finishing, it's going to be at your own risk, because if you don't green time it, it's not going to be that good. Sometimes there's a couple shots on the yellow time finishing that can go in, and that's pretty rare, so it's at your own risk, I think. But now there's multiple ways to score it, and it's different meta of scoring, which I think it's pretty good, because we need a more balanced game. In overall, boss, this is pretty good. Lastly, for the goalkeepers. Goalkeepers, the movement, it was a huge issue last year on FIFA 19, because there was goalkeepers moving like Spider-Man. I think that's what Kurt liked to call it that way. But I do agree that in FIFA 20, you can still move the goalkeeper around, but it's not as much, because like that, it can make things a bit more strategic.
Exactly, boss. And this is as well something really important, because having, like, I remember, especially that vivid memory of like some players that were just moving the goalkeeper around the box each time, it's not really realistic, and this is not what I want personally, boss, in my football game on FIFA. This is not what I want. And as well, boss, last thing, it's about tackling. Whenever you tackle the boy, the ball, and he goes back again to the defender, goes back again to the forward, I think EA Sports needs to adjust this a little bit more about the tackling and defending. Nonetheless, as well, this is something really important, boss, that we want to say, is that whenever you want to master a new skill move, make sure to do it on the arena, because in my opinion, FIFA 20 will be based around skill move. This is my last opinion, boss, regarding the FIFA 20 demo.
And for my last things that I wanted to say in today's video, guys, it will be surrounding the kickoff.
Yes.
From what we play so far, the kickoff glitch or the kickoff boost is not in the game. After Buzz, it's only the demo.
It's only
offline. Hopefully, it stays that way. Obviously, guys, if you make 4 or 5 tackling mistakes, if you guys make a lot of mistakes on the kickoff, then you'll be more likely to concede a goal on the kickoff. But so far, I didn't concede any goal directly from kickoff, like I used to back on FIFA 18, back on FIFA 19. So hopefully it can stay that way. But boys, I know it's only the demo. Let's not get too hyped up, because if you take a look at the FIFA 19 demo, it was pretty similar. But then couple weeks within the game, the gameplay felt completely different. So guys, let's be cautious here. Let's not move too fast on the gameplay, on our opinion. But so far, I like the demo. I spent a lot of hours on this past couple of days of playing the game, trying out new formations, trying out what's overpowered, trying out what's effective, and trying out new players and different teams. So guys, I will give a note of 7.5 out of 10, 8 out of 10 more likely for the FIFA 20 demo. Let me know in the comment section below your grade.
Exactly, boss. For me, I'm not gonna put a grade because I know it's only the demo, and I'm not gonna play the demo when the full game will be released.
But
nonetheless, guys, if you have appreciated today's video, leave a big thumbs up, like Liam said. Let us know your thoughts about the demo, boss, in the comment section down below. We have as well Twitter and Instagram if you guys want to interact with us on those social platforms. Thank you guys so much for watching. Don't forget as well to subscribe if you want to see more videos from Liam and myself concerning our road to glory. This is gonna be as well a big foundation on FIFA 20, boss. Or Road to Glory, I'm really excited to start the Road to Glory, the RTG, the RTG. Twins to Glory. But nonetheless, boys, my name is Vincent.
My name is Liam. We catch you guys tomorrow. Have a great, safe night. We catch you guys tomorrow. Au revoir.